I wasn't quite sure what I wanted to do, like many other teen kids growing up in India. You could study mathematics and become an engineer, or you could study medicine and become a doctor. And believe it or not, the night before when I had to make the decision, I literally flipped a coin and I became an engineer and became a software engineer. I worked for Oracle Corporation in Silicon Valley. I went to UC Berkeley for my MBA in marketing and entrepreneurship. And it is in those days, early 2000s, that I started thinking about social entrepreneurship. And I started thinking about what could I give back to the community where I came from. And I would have these conversations with a lot of Indians working in the Valley that in India, you have a lot of challenges around infrastructure. There's a lot of poverty and what can be done. And then it so happened that there was an extended family litigation of real estate that I got involved in. And I decided to go back to India to deal with this. And I ended up chatting with a gentleman who had just returned from California and they were doing research on biofuels. And so we're doing a lot of things on renewable energy. I said, are you doing anything in solar? And the guy said, no, we are not, but would love to hear about what can be done in solar in India. This is 2007. So people were not taking solar as a mainstream source of energy, being very expensive. And I explained what can be done, that over time, the cost of solar will come down. A few weeks later, I met the Minister of Renewable Energy, who had heard about the meeting and said, we understand that meeting went really well. Are you serious about doing something in India? And that's, I think, maybe the inflection point for me. That I said, hey, you know, I've always wanted to do something socially conscious. So I literally within 48 hours set up a company in Delaware. I looked for Sun Power, it was taken. Sky Power was taken. And then I said, okay, how about Azure Power, right? So I got the domain name registered. I got the company incorporated. I made a proposal. And from there on, rest is history.
Firstly, you didn't become an engineer or you didn't become a doctor in the end. And being an entrepreneur in India was not a common path, let alone being a social entrepreneur. And then on top of that, you took a path into a field of, you know, biofuels, renewables. You know, you'd be the first of your kind, right? So how would you explain yourself to your family, firstly?
I respect my father a lot. He migrated from Peshawar during partition of India and Pakistan. He was 3 or 4 years old. My grandfather had to start from scratch. My father got employed in the insurance sector and he worked there 40 years and retired as the chairman of the company. So when I first came back from US and I told him this is what I want to do, he said, you're being extremely stupid. He said, forget about your plans. Tell me how much time and money are you going to waste before you go back to California?
This is what you expected, right?
Most of the choices I made in my life were not really along the lines of a conservative Indian family. I said, I appreciate your concern, but I'm extremely passionate about this and I believe I'll get there. But if I build India's first grid-connected solar power plant, would you come work for me? Because he is the most experienced person I know on a regulated sector because insurance is regulated in India. So I built the first plant in 2009. He's the chief operating officer of the business and also a director on the board.
Very good. Looking back, if there's one thing you would have done differently, what would it have been?
Nothing really. I don't think I'd change anything. Everything I've done, I think I've done with conviction and passion. And that's an extremely important thing, that once you believe in something, just follow it through. And in the end, you will see success. And if you don't see success, it's not the end.